G'day guys, so for a while now I've been trying to chase down a decent top box for the Africa Twin, and of course plenty of companies out there are doing them, from Lone Rider, Givi, you've got Hepco and Becker, and a number of companies, but you are forking out top dollar, so $1,000, even above $1,000, including the brackets, which got me thinking about Amazon. So I jumped onto Amazon and found myself, for just under 300 bucks, a very suitable, highly rated, mind you, Chinese style top box. So I thought we'd do a bit of an unboxing. We'll get it out, we'll have a look at it, and we'll throw it in the Africa Twin and see how that looks. All right, so the box has got a fair bit of weight to it. We'll crack it open and let's just see what kind of quality we can get out of this little thing. There we go, done. All right, so it seems to be pretty well packed. Let's just bring it down here onto the ground. We'll get it out and have a good look at it. Ooh, yeah, okay. All right, so first impressions, looking pretty good. Everything seems to be in order. There's no dents, scratches, seems pretty firm, pretty clean. Jeez, I'm impressed. Yeah, okay, it's looking pretty good. So far, so good. A couple of bars there which are kind of lightweight, but as you can see, pretty stable. Rivets are all in pretty good nick. The plastic, supposed to be high durability plastic, so that looks pretty good. Locking mechanisms look good. There's your base plate on the bottom there. So we'll take that off and see what we can do with the rest of it. All right, so one thing I've noticed, no instructions in the box. So we're going to be guessing our way through this. Let's have a look at it. All right. I take it the keys are going to be inside. Nice little push button lock. There we go there. Ooh. So that feels pretty solid. There's your base plate. That actually feels pretty firm. Bolts look good. You can move these, so I understand that sometimes this mechanism here can be a little bit loose, so we might need to do some tightening on that. That's gonna basically go down to here somehow, but we'll work on that part in a moment. Not bad. All right, secure that one there. I'm gonna pop open this one here. Good, all right, what I might do, while we've got that, just pinch the Insta, opening it up. Now, I've heard that there's a bad smell coming out of this leather. Ah, not as bad as some say. Nice little lock there. Ooh. Now, I did not expect that. There is a padded seat. Now that, I'm pretty impressed with. On previous videos, I've seen that that isn't included. So happy with that. There's our keys and the bolts and brackets. Now, these bolts and brackets, I understand, are can be a bit on the flimsy side. So, and the tools that they provide, probably not the best at all. So we'll open them up, have a look. We'll do the install, and then we might end up down the hardware shop to get some better quality gear. Don't know yet. We'll play with that idea in a moment. Okay, so a couple of stickers, one that we can't even read, never mind. Reflective bits, handy, I will put those on. Okay. Now, it comes with a logo sticker. I don't even want to try and pronounce that, but that's the logo there. The link for this will actually be down in the comments below and in the description. So if you're keen to check out one of these for under 300 bucks, all included, definitely have a go at that. So far, I'm pretty impressed. It's yeah, it's pretty solid. It's supposed to be 100% waterproof. Kind of like that locking mechanism. That's pretty good. The padding inside which does come out by the looks of it. That's pretty solid. All right, so far so good. The rubber seal around the side there is pretty good quality as well. That'll run around in a kind of a plastic seal. It's kind of a high durability kind of plastic by the feel of it. Yeah, pretty impressed with it, little lock. So what we'll do is we'll get on the bike and see how this goes. Should be interesting. Good times. Come all the way back as far as I can. Get that one. That still seems pretty firm. I reckon I could do that. The alternative was then, if that wasn't going to work, is use the Outback Motor Trek base plate, but I'd only have two bolts sitting there, which I'm a bit dubious about. But look, it's a testing phase, right? Okay, so we're just going to give this a run to see how this fits. I've got a feeling I'm going to be heading down to the hardware shop though, and we'll definitely get some higher quality gear to hold this thing on. It'll be all right for now to just test it temporarily. You know, we're still trying all this awesome steel and everything, and we still can't make decent products. It's hilarious. So that's on, it's pretty stable. It's good enough for a bit of a test run. Don't mind the way that's sitting, but I'm certainly going to change out some of the parts for some higher quality, because you can actually feel it's quite soft, and I don't think that's gonna be a good permanent fixture. Anyhow, let's grab the box. You can see where the fittings all latch in together, and I'll just make sure that's all gonna be pretty good. Let me just jump under here. Now, kind of thing you only really want to put on once, isn't it? All lines up quite nicely. That fits in there. So that's quite firm, quite steady. All lines up quite nicely. Yeah, it's pretty good. I'm pretty impressed with that. For under 300 bucks delivered, and I'm using Amazon Prime, so I get that nice, fast delivery. Free delivery. This was literally overnight, and that's going to work out pretty well on the twin. Yeah, pretty happy with that indeed. That's good. Okay, so yeah, let's have a look at it. We'll test it over the next few days. I'm certainly going to get out and have a better look at other gear, like the bolts, the fasteners, because that does feel nice and stable. Pretty happy with that. I'm just going to do a quick adjustment on this one here. Two keys, and they're very, very basic keys, which that could be a bit of an issue. There is one thing I've picked up as well, which I'll just quickly show you here. As it's locked in, you can see it's not really center, but, and it doesn't look like it's something that could be fixed. So it's like this, they've installed that a little bit too far right, and that's all right. But we'll get under here and I'll just see if I can quickly make an adjustment, because this seems to be one of the most common issues, is how loose this thing can be. So it'll mean moving these bolts, and I'll bring them back in. Let's give that a run and see how that goes, and we'll go from there. But so far so good, pretty happy with it. We'll go for a ride in a little bit and just check it out, see what it's like. Good times indeed, guys. So that's it, $300, 300 bucks. Less than that, delivered. And you know, I'm not the best at installing or doing anything like that, so if I can do it, bloody hell, anyone can. We'll give it a good run. If you want to have a look at it yourself, the link's down below. Go and check it out. It is an affiliate link, so no extra cost to you guys, but a little bit for the channel. And yeah, we'll just see how this travels over the coming months, and we'll do a long-term review a little bit later on. But that's it. It's the iPrudes 45-liter top box. Do want to go anything too big. Still got my Lone Rider gear, but for a daily use, this is going to be perfect. So we'll get stuck into that. All right, looks like I've got some modifying to do to this one here. So I'll get stuck into that. If you've got any questions, throw me a comment down below. Don't forget to subscribe to the channel, and I'm hoping that we can also do a little bit more of this later on down the track. Some installs, some reviews, things like that. All right, well, that was fun. See you next one.
All right, so we're at an undisclosed location. And we've taken the top box off. If you recognize this guy here, this is Warren. Been out before and done a few videos. This is his new toy. What is it?
It's a CNC router mill.
So there you go. And it's fancy, and that's in his garage, and it means that he can start creating some bits and pieces. Action camera mounts and all kinds of different stuff. What material can you use to get it all out of there?
So this one's pretty well upgraded, so it's running all servo motors, and it's over a 3 kilowatt spindle on it, so it'll do pretty much anything I want.
Okay, cool.
So heavier materials like steel need to lighten up.
Yep.
And just take them slow, but it just plows through aluminium.
Cool. So in this case, what we're doing is just getting out the plates, lining them up with the Outback MotoTrek luggage plate I've been using, and we're going to see if we can stick six mil holes in that to then secure to the back of the bike and get the top box on top of that one there. Completely kitted out, so we'll wait and see what kind of damage we can do here. It could be quite interesting, I think.
This is a bit of overkill. We could have just used the drill press.
Yeah, but like blokes who don't read instruction manuals, you want to go the biggest, best, and most fun machine anyway.
Absolutely.
Yeah, so let's go and do that. We'll have some fun with this.
Yeah.
Nice. Okay. So a bit of touching up. Now, putting it on is going to be pretty good. Just some minor touch-up. So the Outback MotoTrek luggage rack is on the back. I'm going to get some longer bolts.
All right, try it again.
Yep. There it is. Firm. Yep. Lockable and firm, not moving. All right, so sorted. Let's get some other bolts to secure it in. But under the Outback MotoTrek luggage rack, which is lighter, it's all secured in there. It's good to know a man with a machine, right? And then
the Outback rack gives you access to these even when it's still on.
Yep, which is great. So, and I feel a lot more confident with this, especially the way it's secured on. It's not going to move. And in time, those lugs under here will wear in a little bit. So I reckon there'll be some slight adjustment to this every now and then. But mate, that's secure. That's not going anywhere. And then I'll go and do a test run out in the bush. You should come for a run.
Yeah.
When it's not 45 degrees in the shade.
Yeah.
Nice work.
Yeah, it's all sitting there. It's nice. It's
yeah. Good. Not bad for under $300 delivered.
Bargain.
Yep. And then the next stage is going to be the test. We'll do a test on it, and that'll be another video. But at this stage, mate, very, very happy with the way that looks.
Go and find some corrugation, see if you can shake it loose.
Plenty of those around here. All right, good times.